Hey guys, Negan here. Welcome to the new Red Dead Redemption series. We have played Red Dead Redemption 2. We've completed Red Dead Redemption 2. Now we're going to move on to the original Red Dead Redemption itself. So further ado, let's get into this episode, guys. I know it's been a while. It's been a lot of time. A lot has happened in the last 3 months in my personal life. That's why I've not uploaded. So, figured I'd come on and start the new series off. And as for the stuff that happened in my personal life, I wish to not go any further on that. Let's just say some of it's not good. But it's also not too bad. It's doable. This is one of my favorite games. Before this released on PlayStation 4, I literally bought an Xbox Series X just to play this game. This game is a pillar of my childhood. So you're gonna see me love this game a lot as we play it. By the way, this takes place after Red Dead Redemption 2. That's why I played Red Dead 2 first, because this is after Red Dead 2, and let's just say this game's gonna be one hell of a ride. It's gonna be really awesome. Oh yeah, those of you that are awaiting. As for new music coming out on the music channel, right now I have halted all operations on that because I want to improve quality on my music and my videos. I'm working on behind the scenes work on that, so there will be zero music videos or really any posts at all on that channel for quite some time. Like, the only thing you may see on that channel is maybe if I start live streaming again, or load up my Twitch account, or whatever, and, I might stream on there, I'm not sure. Bringing civilization to this savage land. I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us. Please, and how we help the natives. This game is so awesome from start to finish. They've gained access to heaven. This game is the definition of the Dying West. That's pretty awesome. Receives communion, they're destined to go to hell?
It hardly seems fair. What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they lived like animals. But they're happier now.
Not everybody, old lady.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
It is 1912.
Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even
it is possible
to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently, the Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
That's true.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other, and who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Indeed.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
Here we go, guys. Here we are. Armadillo. This is so awesome, guys.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to guide you.
They ain't my friends, but pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front.
Okay, so guys. Sorry, Jake, but... Okay, so remember, when we were fishing with Jack in the Red Dead 2, that guy Edgar Ross by Andrew Milton, the guy you saw was Agent with the mustache was Edgar Ross, and the other guy was Agent Fordham. They're with the Pinkerton Detective Agency. The whole plot of this game is that Edgar Ross and the Pinkertons have kidnapped your family, and your goal was to hunt down all the old gang members. This includes Bill Williamson, Javier Escuela, and Dutch Vanderlyn himself. We have to basically take all of them down, bring them in, kill them dead or alive. Then the Pinkertons will give us our family back. I'm not going to spoil the plot twist at the end, but those of you that are true Red Dead fans, you know exactly what plot twist I'm talking about. I'm only saying this for those new viewers, like, because this game came out in 2010, and it's been years of, like, this game was a staple of my childhood. I bet I will, sir. But anyway, this game is easily one of my top favorite video games of all time. Like, I love this game. I love this game more than I love Red Dead 2. I was going as far as to say that.
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bug asking for a guide. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
Yeah. And by the way, the only part of this game I struggle at is the dueling system. Now, when we did Red Dead 2, it was, the dueling was very fluid in Red Dead 2. But for this game, and especially in Red Dead Revolver, I was able to dueling system the second hardest. Now, in Red Dead Revolver, the dueling system is pretty hard. It is even harder, so,
that's because I ain't.
Like, it's pretty, it can be challenging, but it's very satisfying, if that makes sense. I'm pretty good in this game, I'm dueling, but I'm not the best at it, so, yeah. Over the course of this series, you will see me... You'll see me fail a few duels, or fail several, depending on how I do. So,
you'll see the fort when you get to the top of this hill.
So, yeah. By the way, the first game they see this fort, Bill Williamson's in there. All right, and this is one of the greatest video game cutscenes you're about to see. This is one of the greatest cutscenes ever put in a video game.
Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
The Williamson boys.
We part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Oh, I will, sir. I will. All right, guys. Here we go. Time to meet Bill. After all this time. Yeah, get out of here, Bill.
Get out of here right now.
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody oh, you won't kill me, Bill. Now. You're too pathetic to kill me. There you are, Bill.
You always think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh, do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They would kill us all. I can help you.
You never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill, I implore you think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge. No more Dutch. And no more you. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well.
Oop. Well, we're shot.
Poor kid.
Are you gonna make sure I'm dead or let me come out of this alive? Well, we're coming out of this alive, guys. Looks like some ranch folk just saved my life. I like how they got me halfway out of the wagon.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die,
Mr. Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
I was trying to trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. See my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
All right, how much time we got left? Oh, we got plenty of time. Let's go meet Bonnie.
Mr. Marston, back in the land of the living, I see.
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
I sure can use an extra pair of hands around here. Let's see if we can get you back in the saddle. There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up goods for government outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
How do you do, sir? Come on, then. I'll show you around the property.
Come on!
Oh, yeah.
Seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase.
Yep, I have a long outlaw past. My name is John Marston.
That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better.
Good. Good point. Oh, yeah.
Come on, boy. And here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, yeah.
Go.
All right. All right.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot then riding a horse seems to take it out of you.
Oh, yeah.
I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarland.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. We'd best get moving. This is a dangerous time of night for us.
All right. We're kitted out real nice.
Right, follow me. Keep your eyes peeled for anything suspicious. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team.
All right.
I don't believe it. Those damn rabbits are back. Give me a hand with them, will you? Come on, then.
I was trying to use Deadeye, but it's not unlocked yet. Well, Bonnie, I could say they're not coming back for a while. They got shot at. Oh, God, she bugged. We didn't kill any of them because I was trying to use Deadeye and I don't have it unlocked yet. There we go. Now we're getting our bearings. Well, we can at least say.
You know, you can actually handle a rifle.
Yeah.
Had a little experience in.
I'm a highly experienced outlaw. Of course I can.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
This is you, Mr. Marston. Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me kind of happy I saved your life.
Yeah.
Get to sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarland.
Now, I'm gonna, for a custom role for this series, this is gonna be John's primary outfit that he's gonna wear throughout the whole series. Because in this game, there's a lot of good outfits, but I wanna keep the classic, you know, default John Marston. Because in Red Dead 2, there's so many options that are tempting, but in this game, John's classic outfit iconic outfit, especially once we get the bandolier. We really won't need to wear another outfit. But my other favorite outfit is the Deadly Assassin and the Eaglin suit. Those are my top three favorite outfits. Oh, and there's also the Duster outfit that goes with this outfit. Those are usually the ones I end up getting. Then there's the poncho outfit for this. There's a lot of outfits in this game, but you have to do like little challenges and stuff to get them. But for primarily, this is going to be the outfit we wear. Little challenge. Outfit challenge for the series. Make it more interesting. There is a well-dressed outfit you can get, but... I prefer that one's actually my least favorite. Does not fit John. It's like a high class deal. Well, anyway, while we wait for this mission to be done, we're gonna do a night job. These pay pretty well.
Follow Charlie. He's a good one to sniff out trouble. Stay close to Charlie.
All right, Charlie the dog. Where are the threats at? You're barking. Where are they at? Where are they at, boy? Where are they at? All right, boy, where they at? By the way, in this game, instead of John being specifically being an outlaw, John is more like a bounty hunter slash rancher. That's kind of more John's role in this game. And Red Dead 2, which is before this game, he was an outlaw. Now he's basically John's trying to erase his past and make things right with the world. Sadly, the him doing that's going to come at a price. Ooh, we got a threat. Oh, all right. There's a fight. Let's see what we can do. Also, fun tip, loot everybody you can. Because money is very tight in this game. In Red Dead 2, you made a lot of money. You were able to make a lot of money. But in this game, you got to grind. Sometimes you got to grind a little bit for money. Bogor Twins outfit. Entry added. You get these outfits to complete these challenges and these entries, but you don't have to pay for the outfits or nothing. The only outfit I know you got to pay for is the entrance suit. And now there are some steps these outfits where you got to buy what's called a scrap for the outfit. But that's something that, like for the Treasure Hunter and for the Bogor Twins and Walton Gang outfit, you gotta buy, but it's only a little bit of money that you can easily make, no problem. So, but that's why I make so much money that I don't. Oh yeah, see these chests. These are in every safe house you get. Well, you can buy real estate in this game. You can buy like safe houses all throughout the world of the game, pretty much, and You can say where you can sleep, get ammo, free ammo, save the game. There's not really much of a need. Compare this to Red Dead Redemption 2. There's not really much of a need to buy ammo or meds or anything like that. In this game, your health automatically regenerates. It's not like Red Dead 2 and Red Dead Revolver where you have to get meds. But in Red Dead Revolver, you have to rely on meds to be dropped from enemies to get health and all that. But, yeah, it's like, in this game, you're basically immortal, pretty much. Almost unstoppable, immortal, and the gunplay in this game is fantastic. It's really awesome. Well, anyway, we're gonna go to sleep. And, so we can get the missions on with. You know what, Let's go ahead and override this. That's for my first playthrough. Yeah. Oh, Feast Landing. That's another location that's pretty much dead in Red Dead 2. But in this game, it's a flying town. Because Red Dead 2 ends in 1907. This game ends in 1914. Right now, in the current timeline, it's year 1912. So, by then, Feast Landing is a full booming town, pretty much. So let's start this mission. And this will be the...
Mr. Marston, how are you doing today?
The last mission we do.
Farland, thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson, or what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling. See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and by telling you, not only would I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Oh, I'm not.
I saw you get on the train at Blackwater.
Both in real life and in this game.
Bowler hats.
I'm still no city man.
But I bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
Oh, I can ride Bonnie McFarlane.
Take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see. All right, I'll show you how we ride around these parts.
All right. All right.
Three, two, one, go. I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this.
Nope, I'm not being a gentleman. I'm gonna win here. I'm the greatest horse rider in American history. My name is Donald J. Trump, and I approve that message. I'm a very fast rider. I have years of experience doing this mission. Years of experience. Come on. Bring it on. John, she's riding your heels.
You're not as bad as I thought you'd be.
Luckily, this is the war horse. It's got great stamina. It's the bonus horse you get with the game. I own the most expensive version of this game. That's on the Xbox. I have the PS4 version. Come on.
See you at the finish line.
Oh yeah, come on.
Try to keep up, will you?
The stamina in this game on horses does not work like it does. It's weaker in Red Dead 2. I mean, in Red Dead Redemption. Oh my God, I started out with a lead. She's gonna beat me, guys. Oh my god. You see that bar? How it's going from blue to red? Like, this horse is, is actually one of the best horses in the game. But it's, but the stamina goes down on all horses like this, so. Oh, hold on, Bonnie. Oh, guys, I think she's gonna beat me. She beats me. It's about half and half. The AI is very good in this game, by the way. For a 2010 game, the AI is not stupid. Like, I'm trying to find a bow. I'm trying to get a lead here, but I can't. Come, you gotta do. You gotta run a half and half. Come on. Come on. Listen, Bonnie, if I was still under with the Vanderlyn gang, not only would I rob your ranch, I would. That's what happens. You get bucked. Oh, that screwed us over. Yeah, she beat us, guys. It was close. That's what I get for being cocky. We almost won it. We screwed up right at the end.
That was fun.
Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarlane.
You do whatever you think's best, Mr. Marston.
Oh, yeah. All right, how much time? I think we have time for one more mission.
Ah, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarlane. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Take the driver's seat. Come on.
All right.
You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's really. Perhaps there's hope.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't bet on it.
That's how you, Bonnie, I'm the most proficient, sufficient wagon driver in the United States. I go head on, dead fast. Because I don't have time to take this slow, Bonnie. I like my wagon, my guns emblazoned, and my wagon's real fast. Wow. Listen, back in this time, the sexism was a big problem. It still is to this day.
Funny, I found you dying on the side of the road, and now you're driving me into town.
You have a strange sense of humor.
Well, you must admit, it's an unusual start to a friendship.
I didn't realize we were friends, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, please. Now who's being funny? Listen, I know that business with Williamson.
By the way, this is John's, like, second love interest. Let me rephrase that. This is John's Bonnie's love interest. Yeah, Bonnie, the federal government is forcing, crap. I meant to say the federal government is forcing me to do this. I have to bring down Bill, Javier, or Dutch Vanderwin to get my family back.
Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. First one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
All right. Well, let's go into the doctor's office.
Hello, sir.
I got stock of them electric belts.
Thanks.
To lose weight.
Oh, wow.
Howdy, partner.
Tonics are still a thing in this time.
Enjoy the view for once, and a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that.
Costs money. I'm not gonna do that.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
All right, how much time's left? I'll tell you what. No, we're not going to do that mission just yet because there's a certain objective I want to complete. I won't explain that mission, but we need to... Before we do any Marshall Wallman missions, we need to progress the story to get a lasso first. Hey, by the way, guys, fun tip. I'm going to show you how to get back to any, go to any location you want to on the map you want to go to without ever having to pay a stagecoach. You ready? Hold on. First, you need to go out into the wilderness or far enough away from a town. Just outside of a town, depending where you're at. Go here. Go to Kit. Go to campsite, right? Make the campsite. And you see how there's the waypoint? What you want to do is hit double X and travel to waypoint. Go through this loading screen and boom, you should be back at the ranch and you could go... This is so you don't have to travel a bunch. Just to say this, if you're doing a speedrun of this game or you're recording videos and you have like 10 minutes after the video to do something. Good point. Fun tip for all you guys out there. Okay, so guys, I gotta say this has been a first great episode of Red Dead Redemption. I ain't gonna cut it off here, guys. I'm gonna record some. I plan to record many of these episodes like this for the rest of the week, so wherever how many I get out. So, without further ado, this has been your boy Negan. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, tell a friend. Make sure tell the whole world about this channel. Tell the whole world about this great community we all have on here. See you guys on the next one. Goodbye.